There are several ways to get to the input routing block. The input routing block is shown on the scheme here and is available there, or is available through the general tab through the button marking the inputs appropriately. This is the place you can actually change the gain of each channel of the amplifier. Here, you can assign the input you would like. For instance, if I did not want DSP, I could go to analog out, and that would give me no DSP, my analog inputs to my amplifier output. I could engage the analog input to a DSP and then go output. Note that there is a 5 millisecond delay when you engage the DSP. If I wanted to go rear AES out without DSP, I could select that. And I could select rear AES3 to DSP out. At the bottom, these are network inputs. Again, I could go through my AES3 A pair with DSP or B pair with DSP or without. These are the selections. This particular amplifier has been set up with the AES3 DSP out. Above here, whenever you're using a digital input, you will get a choice. You can go to analog backup for channel 1, in which we have a demo of that coming shortly. Or we can mute if no AES3 clock is available. We can also select what channel source we want both channels of the DSP or amplifier are to be seen. So in this case, we could get channel source from channel 1, channel source from channel 2, or a mono mix. This is a minus 6 dB sum for both channels that could be used for a subwoofer. At the bottom, we have an AES3 gain trim. This is used so that when you use an analog backup, you can match the levels properly. Down here where it says repeater, this is the place where if we're using a AES3 coming into the back of the amplifier, this is a point where we can actually use this to make this amplifier a transmitter over the Ethernet cable to transmit up to 2 pairs of AES or 4 audio channels in a network. Also note that any changes on these screens, this screen in particular, the input routing screen, will be applied immediately, whether input gain, whether input selection, a mute, unmute,